Hi, and welcome to this introduction of CAST's new courseware delivery platform. Today we're going to take a look at how to launch and navigate a new UDL course. So let's go ahead and get started. On my Moodle home screen, I'm going to select the course that I'm currently enrolled in. In this case, NYC UDL 101. And when I do, I'm brought to the main course page. And if I scroll down, I'll see all the different activities that I can expect to engage with over the course of the semester. The one I want to focus on today is the link at the very top, the one that says click here to enter the courseware. When I do, what I should see is a new window come up that has in it links to all of the different sessions in the course. This is really where most of the course content lives. So if I click on this, what actually happens is that I kind of get bumped back to this page. And if this happens for you, it's a good indicator that you have a pop-up blocker on and that needs to be removed for this site. Now, every browser is different, Internet Explorer, Safari, Firefox, Chrome, so you might need to Google how to remove pop-up blocks in your browser if you don't already know how to do so. I'll show you how to do it quickly here in Chrome, since I need to do it to launch the course. I'm going to go up here and click this little menu icon in the upper right corner of my Chrome window, scroll down towards the bottom, and select Settings. And that's going to bring me to a new tab in Chrome. You'll see my course is still visible up here. I can still get back to it. In the settings screen, I'm going to scroll down to the bottom to the link that says Show Advanced Settings. Select it, scroll down a bit, click on the Content Settings button. And in this window that pops up, I'm going to scroll down to find the Pop-ups section. I'm going to select Allow All Sites to Show Pop-ups. And click Done. Close my Settings tab, and that will bring me back to the course page. And let's try this again. Much better. And this is really the screen that we refer to as courseware. And depending on your computer, you may want to drag the window around a little bit to resize it, give yourself a little more space in which to see all the content. Now, before we dive in too deeply with each of the different sessions, I wanted to show you quickly the resources that we have available across the course. You'll see here in the upper left that there's three buttons, the first of which is the home screen where we are now. And this is where you'll be able to launch each of the different sessions throughout the semester. Also, we have an information button. If I press on that, we'll see two things come up. We'll have a video that might be a tutorial video or some other media that's germane to the content of the course. And to the right, we have an accordion-style menu that has nested links inside of it. And each of these links, of course, is relevant to this particular course content. All right, the last of the three options we have up here is resources. We find that students often come back to review or repurpose resources that they encountered in this course. And we understand it can be kind of tedious to go through each session in the course and try to sift through all the content and find the links that you're looking for. This is a nice compendium of all the links and resources that are presented throughout the course of this semester. So it's nice one-stop shopping for all the stuff that you might want to take with you for use in your classroom or other professional endeavors. So I'll go ahead and come back to the top here and click back on the home screen to show you how to launch a session. Now you'll see down here that each of the blocks corresponds to a session in the sequence of the course. And each one has a little progress indicator on it. You can see they're all 0% because I haven't started yet. So I can click on this block here, I can click on this one here, either one will launch the course. And when I do, you'll see the screen changes to look like this. What's new here is we have a little navigation bar down here at the bottom. If you don't see it, it could be that it might be just below the fold. You might have to scroll to see it. If you can stretch your window out, that's probably the best solution. But you want to make sure that you have access to those backwards and forwards buttons. Now, because this is a one-screen session, when I click Next, it's just going to take me right back to the home screen. And when I do, you'll see that I have 100% completion here, and there's a little check mark on my block down here to help me gauge my progress and kind of remind me what I have left to do in the course. Now, because I'm feeling particularly ambitious today, I'm going to jump forward into session one just by clicking on the block. And it's going to bring me to the first screen of the session. Now what you'll see here is because we're in a session with multiple screens, there's a few gray blocks down here that correspond to the screens that we haven't gone to yet. And the nice thing about the CAST courses is that you're free to jump around in the navigation. We don't require that you move linearly. So I can jump right ahead to page 3 if I like. When I do, you'll see that there's still a gray bar here indicating I haven't been to this page. So unlike a traditional progress bar that fills up all the way to where you are, This one will show what you've missed or haven't visited yet in case you want to come back and do that. So I might choose to jump back here. I might choose to use my forward and next buttons to move through the course. And on the final screen of this session, we'll see what's called an iframe. It's an embedded window that is linking another website into the course. One of the things that we found is that we have a lot of readings and a lot of resources that we'd like you to go see, but linking out all the time can get a little tedious, you get a lot of windows open, and it's not the best user experience. So whenever possible, we load external resources into the courseware environment. Now, if you're like me and sometimes you want to see the resource in a full-screen, beautiful web browser, there will always be a link underneath here that you can launch to open that website back in a main window. But here you can just sort of scroll through and get a nice view of everything that's inside this particular resource. And when you're done, you can go ahead and click Next and move on. And from here, I'd go on to Session 2, engage with that content, and move my way happily through the course. I hope that you found this introduction helpful. If you have comments or questions or feedback, please don't hesitate to email us. You should see an email address for udlonline@cast.org here at the bottom of the screen. We look forward to hearing from you. Thank you so much, and enjoy your semester.